This is the Rainbow Aviation video channel, and I'm your host, Brian Carpenter. In today's episode, we're going to be looking at bending aluminum sheet metal for aircraft. In particular, we will take an in-depth look at the theory, making a flat layout, calculating bend allowance, and determining setback. This is a companion video for the Technically Speaking article published in the May 2017 Sport Aviation magazine. In this video, we're going to back up a bit and provide some of the theory necessary to understanding how we go about the process of converting a flat piece of sheet metal into a complex sheet metal component. Learning to accurately lay out and bend sheet metal is a very useful exercise. Once you've mastered the process, you will find that it not only saves you a great deal of time, but can also save you a great deal of wasted material. To start with, let's examine some of the properties of aluminum sheet metal used in aircraft. The two most common alloys used are 6061 T6 and 2024 T3. 6061 T6 is one of the least expensive and most versatile of the heat-treatable aluminum alloys. 6061 T6 has a tensile strength of approximately 40,000 psi. It has good corrosion resistance in comparison to 2024 T3, and the current cost per square foot for a piece of 40,000 inch thick material is about $2.53. On the other hand, 2024 is one of the best known of the high strength aluminum alloys. With its high strength, about 50,000 psi tensile strength in the T3 condition, it is used on structures and parts where a good strength to weight ratio is desired. Since corrosion resistance is relatively low, 2024 is commonly used in the clad or alclad form. This provides a thin surface layer of high purity aluminum on the surface of the alloyed aluminum. The cost of 2024 T3 is about 50% more than that of 6061 T6 aluminum, costing about $3.94 per square foot for 40,000 inch thick aluminum sheet. Understanding the properties of each of the aluminum alloys becomes very important during the sheet metal layout and bending process. In particular, the malleability and ductility. By definition, ductility is the solid material's ability to deform under tensile stress, and malleability is the ability of the material to deform under compressive stress. The ductility of 2024 T3 is about 18%. When bending aluminum around a radius, we can see that we are both stretching one side of the aluminum, this is ductility, and compressing the other side of the aluminum, this is called malleability. Extensive testing has shown that the neutral axis during the bending process is about 0.445 times the thickness of the material. Now, the neutral axis is the section of aluminum that is neither under compression nor is it under tension during the bending process. The smaller the radius that the metal is bent around, the greater the differential between the neutral axis and the outside arc of the skin. Additionally, the greater the thickness of material, the greater the differential between the neutral axis and the outside arc of the skin. Stretching the outer skin beyond its limits will normally result in cracking of the aluminum. Of course, there isn't a necessity for calculating minimum bend radius because most sheet metal manuals, including FAA Advisory Circular 4313-1B, have a minimum bend radius chart available for quick reference. The tool which we use for bending sheet metal is called a brake. A sheet metal brake used for aircraft aluminum has either a fixed or interchangeable jaws with a very specific radius built into the jaws. In our shop, we use a 1/8 inch radius. This allows us to bend up to 0.063 thick 6061 aluminum in the T6 condition. It also allows us the ability to bend the majority of sheet metal sizes used in small experimental aircraft. Understanding the necessity for utilizing a radius during the bending process will now help us to understand how to calculate bend allowance. Bend allowance is nothing more than the amount of material that is used for the bent portion of sheet metal. The radius of the bend at the neutral axis is the tooling radius plus 0.445 times the thickness of the sheet metal. Multiplying the radius times 2 will give us the diameter, and multiplying that times pi, 3.1415, will give us the circumference. Taking the circumference and dividing by 360 degrees will leave us with a dimension per 1 degree of bend. Multiplying that times 90 will give us the bend allowance for a 90 degree bend. Although the process of calculating bend allowance is relatively simple, it's made even easier by the use of a bend allowance table. A bend allowance table has a matrix of the most common sheet metal sizes and the standard bending radius already used and calculated for both a 1 degree bend as well as the most common 90 degree bend. When we prepare a piece of sheet metal for bending, we are doing what we call a flat layout. All of the sheet metal components are simply a series of flat sections and bends. Prior to bending up a sheet metal part, we will simply get out a piece of scratch paper and formulate the layout similar to the part that we're going to manufacture. We will lay out each flat section with the bend allowance required for each of the bends. And in this case, because the bends are 90 degrees, the material thickness is the same, and the radius for each of the bends is also the same, we will only need to calculate or look up the bend allowance one time. The amount of material or bend allowance used for each of the bends is identical. Next, we simply need to calculate the length of each one of the flat section. The normal formula for calculating the flat section is the given dimension minus setback. Setback, by definition, is the radius plus the thickness used during the bend. If all of the dimensions were given from the outside of the material to the end of the flat section, this formula would work great. However, there are many cases where you're going to have to extrapolate on this formula in order to calculate the flat section. For example, in order to calculate the length of flat A, the given dimension is from the inside of the bend. In this case, flat A equals the given dimension of 0.375 minus bend radius of 0.125, and that equals 0.25. In our classes, in order to keep comprehension to a higher level, we normally start by teaching bend allowance, as we've shown here, with all of the bends conducted at 90 degrees. Once we've mastered the process of calculating for 90 degrees, we can now venture into the calculations necessary for bends that are more acute or obtuse. We still use setback, which is radius plus thickness. However, this time we multiply times a K factor. A K factor chart is available in FAA Advisory Circular 4313-1B. This is simply another complex mathematical calculation distilled into a matrix which correlates the correction factor to the angle of the bend. To calculate the length of each flat, use the same procedures we used in calculating for a 90 degree bend. Simply take the given dimension and subtract the setback. When calculating the bend allowance for bends that are other than 90 degrees, simply multiply the bend allowance for 1 degree times the number of degrees that the metal is bent. This is the same number of degrees used when calculating setback utilizing K factor. You may have become very proficient at bending aluminum using the old standby method, where you start with an extra large sheet, bend it to the appropriate angle, then cut off excess material to come up with your final dimension. Well, there's nothing particularly wrong with utilizing this method. However, if you have more than one bend, you're going to be in big trouble. This is where I see individuals getting fairly creative by guessing at the dimension, bending the metal, and remeasuring to see how far they are off, and then changing their original dimension by the amount of air in the original part and rebending a new piece. After about 3 or 4 tries, they can get typically pretty close to what you might want. But as you can imagine, this can be quite time-consuming, expensive, and frustrating. If you find yourself working on aluminum aircraft on a regular basis, the amount of effort required to learn to do the sheet metal layout is really quite minimal. Once you've practiced a bit, you can develop confidence and accuracy worthy of a professional. It's very rewarding to go through the process of laying out a fairly complex part with multiple bends and have it fit into the aircraft on the first shot. In part two of this video, we will address some of the more practical aspects of bending aluminum, such as how to place the metal into and set up the sheet metal brake, establishing a sight line, and some other tricks and tips that will help you get well on your way to becoming a sheet metal whiz. Well, we've come to the end of this episode on bending sheet metal part one. We put a lot of effort into bringing you only high quality, useful videos for the sport aviation market. If you enjoy what we're doing, please remember to like the videos. And if you want to stay up to date on all of the new videos that we create, subscribe to our YouTube channel.